This is the site of the historic Mill Creek Dam in Dexter, Michigan. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. The dam here was built around 1824, 1825 by Samuel Dexter on Mill Creek, a tributary of the Huron River. The Huron River is actually just downriver here, maybe about a half a mile. As you can hear, Dexter also had a rail line through here, and that was an Amtrak going by. We're on the main line between Detroit and Chicago here. The water is extremely high today. We have flooding in the area right now. It's about twice as high as it usually is, and probably four or five times higher than it is in late summer typically. So it's not a huge stream, it's not a huge river here, but it was plenty for what they used it for. Let's take a look at what's upriver here. So as I mentioned, it was never a huge dam at all, but it was big enough to actually support two separate mills. Over on the other side of the river, he first built a sawmill 200 years ago, and that was soon followed by the grist mill on this side of the river. The sawmill didn't really last long, but the grist mill actually lasted until 1917 when they shut it down. Until that time, though, the impoundment upriver, was about 22 acres, was actually really popular with the village. It created a good pond for fishing and boating when the water was not frozen. When it was frozen, it was a great place for ice skating and, believe it or not, horse racing, which if you live in the middle of nowhere up in the colder regions of the world here, does make a little bit more sense. The lakes aren't necessarily all that slick when you throw a few inches of snow on top and pack them down a little bit. It's as good a surface to run on as any other. Between the two mills and the economic activity they produced and the recreational activities for the whole community, just up at the impoundment above the dams, the dam definitely produced a positive influence for the community. So in 1920, Henry Ford bought this property. He bought the dam, he bought the mill property on both sides of the stream here, and he planned to use it to create one of his village industry sites. Village industries were small, hydroelectric-powered facilities operated on various rivers and streams throughout southeast Michigan. This site never really was put into production, though. It would have been its newest site, but unfortunately he then died and was never able to open the site. So the original dam was just at the upstream side of this bridge, and by a foot or two, there was almost no space between the bridge and the dam. And in recent years, it had been pretty well overgrown. The rapids here were rebuilt as part of the dam removal. The upstream side was no longer usable for fishing, no longer usable for much of anything really, because it was more of a wetland and less of a pond at that point. Well, in 1957, Ford Motor Company sold the property to the village of Dexter. This allowed for this to be a park. However, the area we're walking through now, as I said, was mostly swampy wetland with a narrow channel cut through it for the stream. So there wasn't a whole lot going on here at that point, and certainly not the nice park we have today. So as we move further upstream, you see that we are still well below the original water level. If you look at the sides, you can see where the banks were set up here. And the water went up kind of to the bottom of the grass line over there. And over on this side, also went up considerably higher. But this whole area was filled up with silt, and it was generally unusable for pretty much anything at that point. We're upriver a ways now from the dam, about halfway through the former impoundment area. In 1995,
the dam removal was recommended. It was too small, too low of water volume. As I said, this is easily twice the normal volume and four or five times higher than the volume that you'd have here during normal midsummer levels. Not enough power to run hydroelectric, not enough power to run a mill, and the dam wasn't in great shape. At that point, it was 100 years old. Henry Ford had rebuilt it in 1920. So they recommended removal of the dam, and conveniently that coincided with them needing to actually replace the road bridge as well. So they combined the two projects together, and they removed the dam in 2008. When you remove a dam, you have to pay a lot of attention to the effects of that removal. And there's a bunch of different effects that you can have. For one thing, upriver of the dam, you're always going to have a lot of silt buildup. Sometimes that silt can actually be pretty hazardous as well, depending on what you had upstream. In this case, there wasn't much upstream that was dangerous. So you're able to come in and pretty easily remove the silt. And the way they did that was by just very, very slowly taking the dam down. They didn't just blast it all out at once. Instead, they took it out slowly, let the water level slowly sink down, and flushed the silt out with it. And that's one of the strategies that's commonly used when doing dam removal, if you're going to actually be lowering the levels behind it. The other strategy is actually to pretty much blow up the dam, get rid of it very quickly, either the whole thing or put a big hole in the bottom of it. And that has some advantages, some disadvantages. An advantage is that it flushes all the silt out pretty quickly. Disadvantage is that you are dumping all of it downriver very quickly. So you have to take those things into consideration. So in this case, they lowered the water level slowly, which maintained the water quality on the Huron River, which, as I mentioned, is like a quarter mile downriver from here. It also allowed for the silt to slowly flush out of this area upstream, and they were able to create this stream channel you see here, which right now is a very healthy ecosystem. So the trail we're walking on is actually a spur trail off of Washtenaw County's border-to-border trail. That trail stretches from Hudson Mills Metro Park in the north, all the way down through Dexter, through Ann Arbor, to Ypsilanti. So as you head upriver here a little bit further, you can see just how healthy this ecosystem is actually becoming. If you look up ahead, you see that we actually have a beaver dam built here on a small branch of the stream. See if we can zoom in on a little bit. The beavers tend to only inhabit places with fairly clean water. The Huron River does typically have very clean water. We also have river otters here, which are another good indicator species for water quality. As we look across the main channel of the stream up into the beaver pond, we can actually see the beaver lodge there. Of course, I can't zoom in very well on it, but if you look at the stand of trees in the middle of the beaver pond, at the far right-hand side, you'll see what looks like a pile of branches with some grass growing out of it. And that's the beaver lodge. So the beavers that built that dam live in that lodge. So 200 years ago, the dam was built here in Dexter, and it created not only industrial opportunities, but it also created recreational opportunities for village residents. Well, it was rebuilt 100 years later and then eventually torn down. And interestingly, that means that today, although the industrial opportunities are gone, we're once again returning back to having recreational opportunities with this great trail here along this Mill Creek, and with a good healthy ecosystem and lots of species moving back into the area that weren't able to be here before. So as we look at the Industrial Revolution, unfortunately a lot of dams are going to be torn down. A lot have already come down. Doing so does cost us some history, but at the same time we gain something else in return. This is one of the options of what we gain, which is restoring the full ecosystem and creating some great recreational spaces for people to come out and enjoy. We'll look at some other opportunities for dam removal in other videos, but today, although it doesn't look it, this is the Industrial Revolution.